Welcome back! In today's video, we'll be looking at ways to try and fix a black or blank screen on a Windows 11 PC or laptop. I take it you are probably watching this on a different device, so hopefully one of the methods will work and we can get you back on your PC. Of course, there's always the chance that the black screen is caused by physical damage to either your monitor or the cables, or even the graphics card. Some of the methods we'll cover will be within safe mode on your PC, as that will hopefully allow us to access the PC. Click the card on screen now to watch my video showing you how to start in safe mode even from a black screen in Windows. You should be able to follow the method in that video on any version of Windows. If your PC screen is still black, even in safe mode, then it's much more likely that the problem is due to connections or ports. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the methods. If the black screen appeared whilst you were working on a document, you can press Ctrl and the S key at the same time to save your work before we look at some of the fixes. The first few solutions will be for those of you that get the black screen before you even have a chance to log in. If this is the case, the most common issue will be with your monitor and connections. However, there are potentially other causes. The first thing to try will be to press the Caps Lock button. This will allow us to test if your PC is responding. If it is responding, you'll see the Caps Lock indicator light up on your keyboard. If the light does appear and your PC is responding, you can try refreshing the screen. You can do this by pressing four buttons on your keyboard at the same time. These buttons are the Windows key, the Control key, the Shift key, and the Letter B key. When you press these together, you'll probably hear a beep and the screen will refresh. If you're using Windows 11 on a tablet PC, you can do this by pressing the volume up and down buttons together three times within 2 seconds. If this doesn't work, we'll continue with some more fixes. It's now more likely that the connection to your monitor or the monitor itself is the problem. There are a few things to try. Firstly, ensure that your monitor display is working. You should be able to check this by bringing up the menu. If that works, the connection is probably the cause. This could mean that the wires or the ports are broken or faulty. Check the ports on your PC, monitor, and on the cables itself for any visible damage. If there is a minor cable problem, you may see an image flicker on the screen. If this happens, you'll need to determine whether it's the cable or the ports. If you have a spare cable, you could try using that. Also, make sure that your monitor is set to the correct input. It might be worth trying all the inputs available just to check. You can also try using another video output on your PC. For example, if you can, use DisplayPort rather than HDMI, or if you have more than one HDMI, use another port. If you're using a laptop, it might be worth taking it to a repair shop to check for any internal connection faults. Also, depending on your keyboard, try increasing the brightness. This method will be different depending on the laptop manufacturer. You can search online for how to do this. You can also try searching your graphics card to see if there are any problems related to it, or if it is even supported by Windows 11. If the monitor, connections, or graphics card isn't the problem, it now could be caused by software. These fixes can be used whenever you get the black screen, whether you are able to log in or not, or even if you get a blank screen with a spinning loading circle. For these solutions, we're going to need to start in safe mode. The video will be linked in the description to show you how to do that, even from a black screen. When you start up, Windows will be running with limited features. Firstly, we're going to try uninstalling any software that may have caused the problem. You'll need to think about any recent software changes that may have caused the black screen. To uninstall software, go to the Settings page. You can get here a number of ways, but we'll be searching for it in the search bar. In the Settings, go to Apps, and then Apps and Features. Find the programs from the list, click on the three dots icon, and then click on Uninstall. If you use any third-party antivirus software, that could be causing the black screen, so you could try uninstalling that. Restart your PC to check if these solutions have worked at any time within safe mode. It may be worth waiting though for a few more solutions, but feel free to try it now if you think software could be the cause. We'll now focus on our display drivers. We're going to check if we can roll back our drivers first. And to do this, you'll want to go to the Device Manager. You can get here by searching for it in the search bar. In the Device Manager, find the option named Display Adapters and click on it. Then right-click on your graphics card and select Properties. Go to the driver tab and now look for where it says rollback driver and click on that if you can. If it's greyed out, we can also try updating our graphics card drivers. You can do that from within here too by clicking on update driver and then choosing the automatic option. Alternatively, you can search for a driver update and download and install it from the manufacturer's website. Use the info of your graphics card in the device manager to download the correct driver for your device. For more help installing the latest graphics card drivers, click the card on screen now to watch my detailed tutorial on that. We'll now try changing the refresh rate of the display within Windows 11. To do this, go to the main settings page by searching for it and then choose system from the options on the left, although you should be in here by default. Now click on display from the list. In the display settings, look for and click on the option called advanced display settings. Make sure your monitor is selected in here at the top, and then look for the section that allows you to change the refresh rate. Change this to a different value and see if that fixes it. It might be worth changing it to all of the available values. If a value doesn't work or makes the problem worse, it will revert back if you don't press anything. Next, think about any additional hardware that you have connected to your PC. This could include things like a USB stick, or a mouse and keyboard, or even a wired internet connection. Try unplugging every device from your computer whilst it is turned off, and then power it on to see if anything makes a difference. This is very unlikely to be the cause, but at least we can rule it out. I know that this has helped me in the past after installing Windows updates, so it's worth a try. If the issue is still appearing after you have restarted your PC, there are a few more things you could try. If you get the black screen after logging in, try and open the Task Manager by pressing Ctrl, Alt, and Delete at the same time, then select Task Manager. Alternatively, you can press Ctrl, Shift, and Escape to open the Task Manager. In the Task Manager, try restarting the process called Windows Explorer. Find Windows Explorer from the list, right-click on it, and select Restart. If you still have the black screen at this stage, you might need to completely reset your PC. Only do this though if you can rule out that the issue is not related to the ports, cables, connections, or your monitor. Try replacing each of these before resetting to confirm it is software related. You can reset your PC by going to Settings, then in the System Settings, choose Recovery, and then Reset PC, and finally follow the options it gives you. Remember that some of these options will delete your personal files, so bear that in mind. Unfortunately, those are all of the methods I have. As always, I will keep the description updated with any new solutions I find, and if any of you find a fix in the future, then it would be great if you could return to the video and post it in the comments to help others. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways you can speed up your Windows PC. Those methods should work on nearly all versions of Windows. Help support the channel by visiting the store, the link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like, and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in another video.